Self-medication has traditionally been defined as the taking of drugs, herbs, or home remedies on one's initiative or on the advice of another person without consulting a doctor. Today we bring you the story of Margaret Namsoke, who was self-medicating for years, explaining her journey. Margaret Namsoke, a 60-year-old resident of Nsambwe Village in Mukono Municipality, suffers from back pain. She says in 2013, she was operated, but 2 years later, she started experiencing back pain that worsened day by day, limiting her ability to work, forcing her to close down her restaurant.
Sama nyoko mwata andikila na yenga anze kuyendaka Gwaso kamu kinyongoza mbili kumine saki Uganongoseza Uganongosa Nata ni mkuma wuni nkandi kukuli mbili mjiange mpola mpola Bumata andi kujikola Makende kulega nga mpuli uguru mbongo Mpuli la buta andi kilizo kundi mpola 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 Nitugenda maso, nitugenda maso Nga kundi mba na inga kuingula yobu kere inga.
She says because of financial constraints, she failed to get full dosage of her treatment. Her pain escalated and she was forced to visit a pharmacy to get some drugs. Upon getting relief with the drugs she was given, Namsoke continued self-medication. After a period of 8 years on self-medication, Namsoke was able to get a Good Samaritan who helped her acquire required treatment from Mulago Hospital, as she narrates. Dr. Vicky Nyombi, a senior pharmacist at Mulago Hospital, breaks down the different levels of pharmacies and she discourages the use of internet for diagnosis.
We discourage patients to Google their different signs and symptoms because they can come up with extreme diagnosis which could actually be a misdiagnosis.
Dr. Vicky further discourages the use of animal drugs on human treatment, and the vice versa is true because some do it for convenience.
Pharmacies within the country, we have pharmacies that are aimed to serve the vet community and those meant to serve human health. Medicines for animals also come in their distinct formulations and dosages, and therefore people who the vet community should not tap into the human health commodity.
Dr. Sabrina Chitaka, a senior pediatrician and a lecturer at Mulago Medical School, has warned parents against medicating children without help of a specialist.
Yeah. So we know that the commonest diseases are infectious in nature, malaria, pneumonia, diarrhea. And these are the ones that parents think they can manage. So if a child gets a high-grade fever, is vomiting, people may rush to self-medicate with anti-malarials. But we need to understand that not every single high fever is malaria. It could be a viral infection. It could be a urinary tract infection. It could be an ear infection. And it may not necessarily be malaria.
During Christmas and festive seasons, many people buy first aid kits to travel with to their villages, while others get food poisoning and choose to take relief medication, something discouraged by professionals. Self-medicating is dangerous as it can lead to several complications and poor health. Potential risks of self-medication include incorrectly self-diagnosing, and taking wrong medication. Report compiled by Sharon Nawasidie for the news.